So my life gets crazy with Brooke and Blake and husband that works 80 hours a day, I mean a week, and I decided to start my own business on top of it, which is insanely crazy. But thanks to the Iowa Clinic, they made it easy to see my doctor. And when I get there, she listens. So I feel like I have a partner. And before you know it, I can get back to my crazy, busy, insanely busy life where I have a busy business, busy husband, and busy twins. Oh no, where's Brooke? There she is. Care how you want it. Visit iowaclinic.com.
What's going on, guys? It's game day for the Clones, 6 o'clock kickoff tonight, Iowa State and Kansas. See if Iowa State can get back on the winning track after a tough one last week in Waco. Yikes. Of course, our presenting sponsors are friends at the Iowa Clinic, the Iowa Clinic Men's Center. You just saw their commercial there. And then also a presenting sponsor this year, Farm Story Meats. Check them out at farmstorymeats.com. I think it's an amazing service. They deliver meat that's born and raised and produced, everything you could think of right here in the great state of Iowa. It comes right to your doorstep. I love the service. Anything you want, brats, steaks, ribs, they got it all. FarmStoryMeats.com. You're supporting a ton of local people when you shop with Farm Story Meats. All right, let's do our top five for today. Thank you for joining us. Of course, we'll have halftime. Brett Meyer and I will be live here on the social media feeds at halftime of the Iowa State-Kansas game. Top five, let's look at the Big 12 preview as we look ahead to today. Really, it is a sexy slate of games in the Big 12 conference. It kicks off at 11 a.m. on ABC. Texas is at TCU. Texas's first road game since announcing that it's going to the ACC. TCU fans already hate them. They hated them before. I don't know if I call this a rivalry, but it's definitely a stinger because TCU and Gary Patterson has had the hand of Texas, and specifically former Texas head coach Tom Herman the last few years. Texas comes in as like a 5-point favorite in this one after just throttling Texas Tech last week. Of course, TCU was upset by its rival SMU. This one's an interesting game because everything would make you think that Texas will go in there and kill them. But man, Patterson's a really good coach. I think TCU will give them everything that they want today. 3:30 Eastern, of course, 2:30 here in the great state of Iowa. Texas Tech is at West Virginia. Of course, West Virginia nearly beat Oklahoma a week ago, and Oklahoma is at Kansas State, a.k.a. kryptonite for the Sooners, who go in as a 10.5-point favorite. No Skylar Thompson today for Kansas State. They have no offense. Kansas State has no offense right now. So how much can they junk it up and special teams touchdown? You guys know how Kansas State football is. That's what they're going to have to do to make it three in a row against Oklahoma. I don't think that they have a chance today. I think the Sooners come out of their little shell wherever they've been at the first few weeks. I think they blow them out. We shall see. Of course, Iowa State, Kansas. And then I think the game of the week in the conference is Baylor at Oklahoma State. That's a night game as well. 6 o'clock, ESPN2. Kind of a prove-it game for Baylor, I think. They got on the radar after beating Iowa State last week. Oklahoma State, I believe, is legit. I think they're a very similar football team to what we have with our Cyclones. So with that, let's go to Iowa State and Kansas. What are we looking for tonight? Number four in our top five, I want a fast start from Iowa State. No hanging your heads, none of that. Come out firing tonight. Get up 14-21-0. In the first quarter. That's what I want. I don't want this to be a lingering around, nothing like that. You're better than Kansas. Don't let this Kansas team, don't give them any breath, right? Last week, the slow start really killed Iowa State. It ended up doing that. So get off to a fast start tonight. Number three here on our top five as we enter tonight's game is the running game. Really saw some progress last week with Breece Hall. He finally looked like Breece Hall. Right. He was running with a totally different type of, I don't want to say passion, but definitely a different type of energy against Baylor last week. Iowa State averaged 6.6 yards per play offensively. So that was big time progress that you like to see. I want to see that continue on, go into the bye week, get everybody healthy. But a running game is what I'll have my eye on offensively. Number two today is special teams. Listen, sure, no, you don't want Kansas to return a kickoff or a touchdown. To me, it's the punt game, man. Like, you got to have some consistency in this punt game. I wrote a column about it yesterday. And I don't even know. Like, they've been so inconsistent with the punt game. It's like, okay, even if they go out there and have a good game, it's like, do you trust that it's going to continue on? I don't know. But, yeah, you sure want to see The special teams get cleared up because that cost Iowa State the game last week in Waco. Last but certainly not least, this is not great analysis, but I want Iowa State to dominate tonight. Dominate a team that you're a 34-point favorite over. Don't let them hang around. Don't give anybody a reason to doubt you. Come out with a fast start and crush the Kansas Jayhawks tonight. Everybody needs confidence right now, from the players to the fan base. And then let's go out and, for Iowa State football, make a statement to the country that you have not rolled over and died. Have a really good taste in your mouth going into the bye week. And then you come back and you got a tough game against Kansas State on the road following that up. But dominate Kansas tonight. Do not let them hang around. None of that. Don't give people a reason to talk. Crush this team. Crush this team. Cover the spread at halftime. I'm serious. That's what I want to see tonight out of the Cyclones. Thanks to our friends at the Iowa Clinic and the Iowa Clinic Men's Center, Farm Story Meets, Maddie Van Winkle for the production of today's pregame show. Of course, join us at halftime. Brett Meyer and I will have your halftime report. Jared Stansberry and Rob Gray will be live from the press box at Jack Trice Stadium following the game, usually about an hour after the game. And I will, of course, have the Instant Reaction podcast. Sign up wherever you listen to your podcast. Please rate, subscribe, review, share our work. We appreciate it. We appreciate you. Have a great college football Saturday, guys.